Good morning, students. Today we are going to study the lesson Electrostatics. Before going to this topic, we must know what is meant by electrostatics and electric charge. Study of electric charges at rest or stationary charge bodies. Then we will see what is meant by electric charge. Electric charge means a basic property of some substances due to which they can exert a force of electrostatic attraction or repulsion on other charged bodies at a distance. Then we will see electric dipole and electric dipole moment and electric field intensity. First, we must know what is meant by electric dipole. Electric dipole means two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance constitute an electric dipole. Electric dipole means two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance constitute an electric dipole. Examples: CO, water, ammonia, HCl. Then we will see electric dipole moment. It is defined as the product of the magnitude of one of the charges and the distance between them. Electric dipole moment is equal to the product of the magnitude of one of the charges and the distance between them. The electric dipole moment can be represented by the symbol P. The formula for electric dipole moment is P equal to Q into 2A. Q is the charge, A is the distance. So electric dipole moment is a vector quantity. What is the unit of electric dipole moment? The unit of electric dipole moment is coulomb meter. Unit of electric dipole moment is coulomb meter. Then we will see the electric field intensity. Electric field intensity can be represented by the symbol E. Electric field is defined as the force that would be experienced by a unit positive charge placed at that point. Let F be the force, Q naught be the charge. So E equal to F by Q naught. So electric field intensity equal to force by charge. The unit of electric field is Newton per Coulomb, or you can say NC inverse or NC minus 1. A unit of electric field is NC minus 1. So it is a vector quantity. Then we will see the expression for electric field due to an electric dipole at a point on its axial line. It's a very important 5 mark question. Write down the question. Derive an expression for electric field due to an electric dipole at a point on its axial line. Then you draw the diagram. The diagram is very important. Let us consider two points, A and B. O is the midpoint of AB. They are separated by a distance A, 2A. Then C is the point at a distance R from O. The charge plus Q is placed at B and the charge minus Q is placed at A. C is a point at a distance R from O. So let us see the explanation. AB is an electric dipole. Two charges plus Q and minus Q are separated by a small distance 2A. C is a point on the axial line. C is at a distance R from O. Now you have to find out the electric field at the point C due to plus Q. First, we must calculate the electric field at the point C due to plus Q. Electric field at C due to plus Q is E plus vector. That is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r minus a the whole square p cap. P cap is a unit vector. Now you have to find out the electric field at the point C due to plus q is along PC. So you have to find out the value for PC. So first you have to measure the distance CO. CO is R, and the value for BC is R minus A. Then we will find out the electric field at C due to minus Q is, that is E minus vector. Now you have to find out the electric field at C due to minus Q is E minus vector equal to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R plus A the whole square P cap along AC. So the value for AC is, that is CO. Measure the distance CO, that is R plus A along AC in bodhi CO distance R, that is R plus A the whole square. P cap is the unit vector. Now you have to find out the total electric field at the point C. Find out the value for the total electric field. So U E total vector equal to E plus vector plus E minus vector. Then substitute the value for E plus vector and E minus vector. So E total vector equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R minus A the whole square P cap minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R plus A the whole square P cap. Take out the common terms, that is Q vector Q P cap by 4 pi epsilon naught is common. So E total vector equal to Q P cap by 4 pi epsilon naught. Remaining terms, that is 1 by R minus A the whole square minus 1 by R plus A the whole square. Now you have to find out the LCM. That is the LCM for both the terms, that is R square minus A square the whole square. The formula for A plus B into A minus B equal to A square minus B square. So here R square minus A square the whole square. So the E total vector equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught P cap R plus A the whole square minus R minus A the whole square divided by R square minus A square the whole square. Then expand the value for A plus B the whole square and A minus B the whole square. Here A R plus A the whole square. That is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught P cap R square plus A square plus 2 R A minus into R square plus A square minus 2 R A divided by R square minus A square the whole square. Then next term Q P cap divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square plus A square plus 2 R A multiply the minus term with the bracket terms. Multiply by minus term with the bracket. Minus R square minus A square minus into minus plus 2 R A. Then find out the total value, that is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught P cap 4 R A divided by R square minus A square the whole square. This is the value for E total vector. The point C is far away from the dipole. The point C is far away from the dipole. So R is very much greater than A. So neglect the values A square term. So the A square can be neglected. E total vector equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught P cap 4 R A divided by R power 4. Then the 4 can be split into 2 into 2. Next equation, that is E total vector equal to Q P cap 4 pi epsilon naught 2 into 2 Ra divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R power 4. Here numerator 1R, denominator 1R get cancelled. Remaining values Q P cap 2 into 2 into A by 4 pi epsilon naught R cube. So the value for dipole moment is P equal to Q into 2A. Substitute Q into 2A equal to P from the above equation. So E total vector equal to 2P vector divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R cube. So E total vector equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2P vector divided by R cube. So the direction of electric field is along the dipole moment. The direction of electric field is along the dipole moment. E total vector equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2P vector by R cube. So this is a very important question. This is the expression for the electric field due to the electric dipole at a point on the axial line. Thank you.